I found a love for me. Well, darling, just dive right in and follow my lead. Well, I found a girl, beautiful and sweet. Well, I never knew you were the someone waiting for me. Cause we were just kids when we fell in love, not knowing what it was. I will not give you up this time. Well, darling, just kiss me slow. Your heart is all I own, and in your eyes, you're mine. Baby, I'm dancing in the dark with you between my arms, barefoot on the grass, listening to our favorite song. When you said you looked a mess, I whispered underneath my breath, you heard it, darling, you look perfect tonight.
Well, I found a man stronger than anyone I know. Shares my dreams. I hope that someday we'll share our home. I found love to carry more than just my secrets, to carry love, to carry children of our own. We are still kids, but we're so in love, fighting against all odds. I know I'll be alright this time. Darling, just hold my hand. Be your girl, you'll be my man. And I see my future in your eyes. Oh, baby, dancing in the dark with you between my arms, barefoot on the grass,
listening to our favorite song. When I saw you in that dress, looking so beautiful, I don't deserve this. Darling, you look perfect tonight.
Anomaly. and I'd choose you. In 100 lifetimes, I'd choose you. In 100 worlds, I'd find you. And I'd say I do. For the rest of my life, with all that I have, I do. And I will. When the sky is falling, I promise you I'm all in. No turning back. And every day, every moment, every breath you take, I choose you. This is more than just a wedding. This is etched into eternity. With our union, we will move mountains. We will live on our knees. 'Cause he'd choose us. In 100 lifetimes, he'd choose. In 100 worlds, he'd find us. And we'd say we do. For the rest of our lives, with all that we have, we do. And we will. When the sky turns black and he comes back, every day and every moment, every breath we take, we choose you.
Outside. all so very welcome here today to the marriage of Emer and Martin. And on their behalf, I would like to extend their thanks to you all for attending the wedding today and making it a truly memorable occasion for them. I feel very honoured and blessed to be asked to officiate at this wonderful occasion. As today marks a new beginning in the lives of Emer and Martin, and they have chosen you, their very special family and friends, to be here to witness and celebrate this very special and important time in their lives, when they will proclaim their love for each other and their commitment to live their lives as husband and wife. And so, Emer and Martin, it is with the greatest love and gratitude we come together in the sight of spirit, all those gone before us and all here present, we celebrate your togetherness. So, what is marriage? A joyful marriage has never been too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say I love you. It is never going to sleep angry. It is at no time taking the other for granted. Let your courtship not end with the honeymoon, but continue throughout all the years. Your marriage will be a great journey of surprises, joys, and miracles. No ceremony can create your marriage. What this ceremony does is bear witness and affirms the choice you have made to begin a new life today as husband and wife. Marriage is not an event, it's an inner spiritual journey. To make this marriage work, however, will take more than love. It will take trust, to know in your hearts that you want only the best for each other. It will take dedication to stay open to one another, to learn to grow even when it is difficult to do so. It will take courage to honour your differences, to make the important things matter and let go of the rest. And it will take faith to go forward together without knowing what the future holds for both of you. So be who you are, say what you feel, because those who mind don't matter. And those who matter, they don't mind. And on this very special day, Emer and Martin would like to remember those who have left this world and those, though not physically here to share this special day with us, but of course are here in spirit. And we especially remember and hold close in our hearts Martin's dad, Lar, and his lovely grandaunts, Betty and Josie. And of course we remember Emer's grandparents, Anne, Patrick, Kathleen and Liam, and Emer's lovely uncle, Harry, who, while working quietly from the world of spirit, have had a huge hand in guiding events that have led us here today. So I'd like to invite Christine to come and join us now for our first reading.
Now you will feel no storm, for each of you will be sheltered by the other. Now you will feel no cold, for each of you will be warmed by the other. Now there is no loneliness, for each of you is companion for the other. You are two persons, but there was one life before you and one home. Turn together and look at the road you travelled to reach this, and in this hour of happiness. It stretches behind you into the past. Look to the future that lies ahead. A long and winding adventure-filled road whose every turn means discovery, new hopes, new joy, new laughter, and a new few shedded tears. May happiness be your companion. May beauty surround you both in your journey ahead and through all the years to come to this day and to your dwelling place, and enter into your day together. May your days be good and long upon the earth. Your adventure has just begun.
Well done, Christine. Thank you.
When you don't need an answer, there'll be days like this. When you don't meet a chancer, there'll be days like this. When all the parts of the puzzle look like they are gonna fit. Oh, I must remember, there'll be days like these. When everyone is up front and they're not playing tricks. When you have no freeloaders trying to get their kicks. When everybody minds their business and you live your life. Oh, I must remember, there'll be days like this.
What is a soulmate? If you have found a smile, that is the sweetest one you've known. If you have heard within a voice the echoes of your own, if you have felt a touch that stirs the lungs of your heart and still can feel the closeness in the moments you're apart, if you have filled with wonder at the two lives can blend to weave a perfect pattern that is seamless end to end, if you believe some things in life are simply meant to be, then you have found your soulmate, your heart's own destiny.
Well done, Philip. Thank you. Thank you. And I'd like to invite Liz and Paula to come and join us now for the lighting of the Unity candles. Emra Martin, your mothers gave you light by bringing you into this world. It is only fitting that that light continues to guide you now and help you on your journey together as husband and wife. It's grand. Emra Martin, in the lighting of this Unity candle, you symbolise your lives as both individuals and as a couple. The two outer candles represent your lives up to this moment. They are two distinct lights, each bright and shining on their own. Thank you, ladies. Do you, Martin, hereby state that you have read and understood the list of civil impediments to marriage? And do you solemnly declare that you believe there is no impediment of kindred or affinity or other lawful hindrance to your proposed marriage with Emer?
I do.
Of course you do. And do you, Emer, hereby state that you have read and understood the list of civil impediments to marriage? And do you solemnly declare that you believe there is no impediment of kindred or affinity or other lawful hindrance to your proposed marriage with Martin?
I do.
It is now that I, Bernadette Dolan, in accordance with the rights of the Spiritualist Union of Ireland, do solemnise this your marriage according to the laws of this country and the laws of spirit. Before you, Emer and Martin are joined together in the presence of spirit, my presence, and the presence of these witnesses. I am bound, as you know, to remind you publicly of the solemn, the serious, and the binding nature of the relationship into which you are now about to enter. Marriage, as most of us understand it, is the voluntary and full commitment of two people to each other. It is made in the deepest sense to the exclusion of all others and is entered into with the desire, the hope, and the firm intention it will last a lifetime. So, Martin, do you take Emer marriage to be your wedded wife, to share your life as your friend, your lover, your companion, to grow together in spirit and in truth, and forsaking all others?
I do.
You do. And do you, Emer, take Martin in marriage to be your wedded husband, to share your life as your friend, your lover, your companion, to grow together in spirit and in truth, and forsaking all others?
I do.
Wedding bands, been a perfect circle, have no beginning and no end. But we all know these rings do have a beginning. Rock is dug up from the earth. Metal is liquefied in a furnace at 1,000 degrees. Hot metal is poured into a mould, cooled, then painstakingly polished. Something beautiful is made from raw elements. And love is like that. It has to be worked. It is a process of making something beautiful where there was once nothing at all. And Emer and Martin are now ready to give and accept that symbolism of love. So do we have those rings? These rings will forever show the world you are one.
Emer, with this ring I marry you.
Emer, with this ring I marry you.
Wear it as a sign of my love.
Wear it as a sign of my love.
Martin, with this ring I marry you.
Martin, with this ring I marry you.
Wear it as a sign of my love.
Wear it as a sign of my love.
I want you to just stay holding hands there for a minute, okay? It's staying on. So Jonathan's going to come and join us now as we enter into the hand fastening ceremony. Now, what I want you to do. These are the hands of your best friend, full of love for you, that are holding you on your wedding day as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. Back you come. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you throughout the years, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will help to hold your family as one. And these are the hands that, even when wrinkled and aged, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. So, Jonathan, are you going to tie the knot or will I? Go on then, good and tight. Good man. So, Emer and Martin have declared before us they will live together in marriage. They have made special promises to each other. They have symbolised it by joining hands, taking vows and exchanging rings. So therefore, on your behalf, on behalf of the community and the Sight of Spirit, I now have the greatest pleasure in presenting to you for the very first time, Martin and Emer, husband and wife. Martin, you may kiss your bride. Emer and Martin, I would like you to remember a time in your relationship when you realised that you were truly in love with each other and wanted to spend the rest of your lives together. And I'd like to invite you all to now bring to mind your wishes and blessings for Emer, Martin and Ava's future lives together. Emer, Martin and Ava, in the lighting of this unity candle, you are symbolically expressing the dreams and goals of your union and your marriage. And this has been amplified now by the wishes and blessings being made by your family and friends. And we ask that the love and the light that will radiate from these beautiful blessings will touch the lives of all those you meet. So Ava, today is not just about your mum and dad getting married. Today is also about celebrating you as a family. Your mum and dad have bought you a beautiful gift, a beautiful cladder ring as a memento of today. So as you grow older and travel the world, when you think back on today, you will always remember that you are and you always will be the centre of their world. Well done, Ava. Big round of applause.
Congratulations. I hope you fall in love with life, with music, with art, with books, that you find yourself swimming under the moon and dancing amongst the wildflowers. I hope your eyes stay open to the magic that surrounds you each and every day, and not for a single second of this life you forget your magic too. I hope you chase your most vivid dreams with reckless abandon, and you reach for the stars because everything is possible. I hope you set your soul on fire with the things you love, that your life is filled with adventure and unexplored places, nights that leave an imprint on your heart, and people that appreciate the unique perfection that you are. I hope you recognise that life is a gift and one that you must never take for granted, that you are overflowing with gratitude and for love for the beauty and magic and miracles constantly occurring around you. Thank you.
Well done.
Bless Emer and Martin's families and friends and the relationships which have supported, strengthened and sustained them throughout their lives.
For Emer and Martin, that God will watch over them at every moment, keep them safe and grant them rich blessings of health and happiness.
May the love of Emer and Martin be patient and gentle, ready to trust and endure whatever life brings. May their home be a place of laughter, understanding and kindness.
Today we remember the smiles and laughter of all those who have gone before us. We thank God for the happy memories they have left with us.
As Emer and Martin learn from one another, may they grow stronger as individuals and closer as husband and wife.
We pray for the private intentions of all here present, that God may grant you and your loved ones your wishes and guide you happily through life.
So I'd like to finish up now with a little closing prayer for Emer Martin. Spirit of love and life, out of this world, two souls have found each other. Their destinies shall now be woven into one design, and their joys shall not be known apart. Emer Martin, may your home be a place where the old and the young are renewed in each other's company, a place for growing, a place for sharing, a place of love. May those who are nearest to you be constantly enriched by the beauty and the bounty of your love for one another. May your work be a joy of your life that serves the world, and may your days be good and long upon the earth. So, ladies and gentlemen, to conclude this ceremony, would you please be upstanding as I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Council.
We used to be giants. When did we stop? Just say the word and I'll be yours. You know I never forgot. The hope and the hurt has lived inside of me. But there's gold in the dirt I never took the time to see. But I knew of its worth when you walked beside of me. And my hand fit in yours like a bird would find the breeze. We used to be giants. When did we stop? Song in the silence, but time catches up. Just say the word and I'll be yours. You know I never forgot. I knew from the start you'd be the one to set me free. That day in the park when the hurt would hide from me. Those eyes used to know me. It's been way too long. Never forgot. We were the song of the silence. But time catches up. Just say the word and I'll be yours. You know I never forgot. We used to be giants. Giants. Oh, I still love you though. I still love you though.
Story. I wanna know who you are. I want your heart to be for me. Oh, I want you to sing to me softly. Cause then I might run in the dark. That's all that love ever taught me. Oh, I call and I'll rush out. All out of breath now. You got that power over me. My mind, everything I hold dear resides in those eyes. Got that power over me. My mind, the only one I know, the only one on my mind. You got that power over me. You got that power over me. You got that power over me. Remember the lake and the moonlight. Remember you shivered and shone. I'll never forget what you looked like on that night. I know that time's gonna take me. I know that day's gonna come. I just want the devil to hate me. Oh,
rush out. All out of breath now. You got that power over me. My mind, everything I hold dear resides in those eyes. You got that power over me. My mind, the only one I know, the only one on my mind. You got that power over me. You got that power over me. You got that power over me. It was rolling down the road, the road. So we had a way and never tell. You decide if darkness knows you well. That lesson of love, all that it was, I need you to see. You got that power over me. My mind, everything I hold dear resides in those eyes. You got that power over me. My mind, the only one I know, the only one on my mind. You got that power over me.
And we hope you have a fantastic evening with us. But for now, may I ask you to all be upstanding and make a huge cheer for the first time this evening for the new Mr. and Mrs. Cantor!
Afternoon, folks, and welcome to Emer Martin's big day at last. This is a day that they have been looking forward to for a long time, that even a pandemic couldn't stop. I have to say, Emer looks beautiful today. As do Olivia and Ava. All the groomsmen and the bridesmaids. We first met Martin about 10 years ago and took to him straight away, to be honest. Emer brought Martin home and was introduced as the Liverpool fan from Ringsend. Who loved Westlife. Now, the Liverpool fan I can have, but Westlife, I don't know. But he still got away with that one because he told me Nicky Bourne played for Leeds. Finally, myself and Elizabeth are delighted to welcome Martin as our new son-in-law and would like to thank Paula for raising such a gentleman. That's all, folks, and I hope you have a great evening. That's all. All right, thanks.
Now, so ladies and gentlemen, our next speaker is the main man himself, the Joe Groom, Martin!
Yeah.
Nice and Eddie, short and sweet, love it. Right, folks, I'm going to be the same myself and Dale. Haven't slept for about 3 weeks thinking about doing this, so it's going to be very quick. First and foremost, just want to, from my wife and I just want to say thanks to each and every single person that's here today. Obviously, last year, the last 2 years were a shit 2 years for everybody, so to finally get to have the day today is amazing. Everybody looks terrific. a special mention, once everything was going on, obviously we need to reschedule with vendors and stuff like that. Bellingham Castle and the staff couldn't be more accommodating for us. So I'd just like to give a big cheers to the staff and everybody here today. Don't be shy tipping there, Thomas. We have a little candle going here, obviously, in remembrance of everybody that couldn't be here today. I lost my father this year, which obviously was tough on the family. Everybody, the lads here were myself and Grace and also Emer and everybody around us, our family. So I'd also like to give a big mention to two people who would have been a very big part of this day. My Auntie Josie and my Auntie Betty, they would have been killing each other here today, but they would have been here having the crack. So it's a big thing that they're not here, but look, I want to raise a glass to everybody that's passed. I also want to give a big mention to someone who I know would have been a big part of our day and also of Emer's life, which is our cousin Paolo, that tragically passed away a few years ago. So also want to give a big mention to Paolo. So cheers to everyone. Right, moving on to Emer's mum and dad. Obviously, as Eddie said, about 10 years ago, pretty much took over the house for a while. The first few times of going into the house, Liz would always have on her little phone voice going around. Jesus. Ian's car got very posh very quick. She obviously knew it from D4 myself, so I'd say that's what she was putting on for. So after a while, she calmed down. We actually both realised that we were raised in the flats, so she kind of she knew the sus then. And in fairness to her, we've took away from our big day today. It's actually Liz's birthday today, so I just want to say a big happy birthday to Liz. But no, honestly, like, obviously when Ava was born and stuff like that, we were living in Liz's house and Eddie's, but mainly Liz's house. But honestly, the acceptance that I had from day one was amazing from Jess, Kev, Phil. Liz still gives out to me, look, I'm her own son, so that's a good sign. Yeah, honestly, we have a small token of appreciation for both of you, which I'll hand over to you now. Couldn't get Eddie Liverpool tickets, so we settled for Leeds. The part that I have to get through without crying. My mum, firstly, I just want to thank you for every single thing that you do for us. Obviously, coming from Markovich House, we used to live off crispy pancakes and meatballs for dinner, but we're in a castle now. You made it. I think I still have a scar on my chest from when them crispy pancakes falling on me, but we'll get over it. Obviously, my ma had a great 6 years, the first 6 years of having me. And then Jay came along. And he caused havoc since. But he did teach her one vital skill that you probably still have to this day, to be honest. you could bend anything around the corner, whether it be a slipper or a blade and bottle. Catch the ear off, you're not a bother. all jokes aside, there's probably no one in the room that, on my side of the family anyway, that my ma hasn't helped in some, any sort of way. You're an absolute star, I swear to God. Like, it's hard to describe to someone how much she does for everybody else but herself. She's the most selfless person I've ever met in my life, and I love you so much. I also have a small token from my mum as well, even though she doesn't like flowers, but...
I told him not to get it.
Last but certainly not least, to my wife, sounds shout. Honestly, I really want to thank you for giving me a dig out with planning everything the last few weeks. It's been tough, but we got there. No, but honestly, I basically, like everybody else in this room, just turned up today and everything was there. So you've done a great job organising everything. Just to give you a sample of what we were dealing with a few weeks ago, I was sitting down at the kitchen table with Emer and she was throwing loads of stuff at me and scrolling the phone. I was like, look, we have a little trip planned up, and I was looking at everything we could do for that trip, basically. I was thinking, geez, look at this, Emer, we can do this, we can do this. And she just looked at me, she was like, we have a blading wedding to plan. Oh no, sorry. She said, we have a wedding to go to. I was thinking to myself, geez, I thought all the lads' weddings were out of the way. I was like, whose wedding? She goes, yours, you fucking gobshite. So, That was what she was putting up with. Throughout the last 10 years, obviously we made some incredible memories. And the biggest gift of all was obviously our beautiful daughter, Ava. In saying that, if we have another daughter, I'm moving to Yemen because I can't put up with another Amor in the house. Ava absolutely idolises you, loves the ground you walk on, even so much so that about 4 weeks ago we were playing with Barbies and we got a little bit of dispute about what Barbie I was going to play with. She wasn't happy with the outcome of it, so she looked up at me dead in the eye and said, if you don't like it, you can pack your bags and go to your ma's. So... I'm not really sure where she got that from, but so look, we'll deal with it. I don't think there's anyone I could look at and love more. We kind of came close, as Eddie said. I was at Westlife a few weeks ago, and before they sang Flying Without Wings, Nicky Bourne looked me dead in the eye. But that was a close anyway. But all joking aside, couldn't be proud of you. Honestly, master's degree, motherhood, you've literally took everything in your stride. I look forward to a life of happiness and more incredible memories made with you. I just want to say a big cheers to my now wife, Emer. On a side note, I've been warned that I'm not allowed to do shots before 12 o'clock. So if anybody plans on buying me one, 12:01 will do. But lastly, folks, I just want you all to have such a good night. We've waited for this night for about 4 years now, and we want everybody to have a great time. So thanks, everybody, for coming. Appreciate it. Thanks.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, on to our last speech this evening. It's your best man, Derek!
Eddie, you're some snake. You said you had 14 pages. I was talking at least another half an hour. I believe at least the door's there. I might do a burn in the next 20 seconds. So. just say good afternoon, evening to everyone. It's like a glad day, Martin and Emer. Unbelievable day. I think we can all agree that it's turned out to be an absolute amazing wedding. Yeah. As he said himself, I'm going to keep this short myself because I see a few hungry looking people and they're looking at me. I can feel like a glass is almost going to come up this way. So, especially lad over there, he's very hungry. So, he already told me to keep it short. So, I've been very worried about giving the speech for a good while. Many, many sleepless nights. Fortunately, last night I slept like a baby. Where I woke up every 2 hours bawling my eyes out. I'm Derek, Martin's best friend, and today his best man. Martin has many close friends, and for some reason, he chose me. I had to think about it. I said he only picked me because he knows I would hate doing something like this. Doesn't even like me. Just knew. He won't like doing this, so I'll ask him to do it. Then I actually had another thought about it. I said, well, Thomas here beside me. I'm actually shocked he found his way to the table. Very special lad, this lad. I'm actually shocked he knew how to dress himself, in fairness. And then I thought, Jake, maybe he could have done it. And I was like, he's from Cavan, so it's not really meant. And you're not slagging the calf. And I was like, Jay, good friend, is whatever. I said, I'm not saying that about him, he'll be punching his head on me, so. I'd just like to say a few thank yous as well before I continue. It was to the lovely bridesmaids, Jessica, Rachel, Carly and Lindsay. It all looked great. Emil's father, Eddie, who I'd say without him today, I'd say the wedding probably be in local in Ninja Court or something. Especially the glamorous mothers Paul and Liz, who say y'all look wonderful, you've done an excellent job today. All only eclipsed by Emma himself. I'm sorry, all agree he looks absolutely stunning. Thanks to the groomsmen, he's done a good job just standing there looking pretty anyway. Where do I start with Martin? I don't actually know. How do we? I've known Martin since we were very young kids. We first met playing for a local Cambridge boys team in Ringsend. He came from Markwich, so nobody really wanted to be his friend because nobody wants to be friends with anyone from Markwich, trust me. Nobody wanted to take him in, so I said, right, we'll take Martin in. But then now I think I said, if I had known 20 years later, he would have asked me to do the speech, I would have left him on his own. We've gone through so much together, from drinking cans of Bavaria in the park. We used to have a little treehouse where we used to hide from my mother and his mother, Polly. We hide there, so we were drunk, so we didn't want to go back. We were only 12, so. Many trips watching Liverpool around Europe. To now was wedding day, which I don't think any of us thought this would ever happen, like, let's be honest. Martin was actually the first one of us in our group to get a car. I know, I'll say a few people know Martin are thinking, but Martin doesn't drive. Never drove the car. We used to just sit in the car and order Domino's pizza to it. That's why I had to bleed and change my life to it as a fat piglet. Because of him. The love Martin has for his family though is incredible. Something I've always admired. If you've ever been to any one of even Jay's fights, you'll know just the way he screams like a little girl. It's embarrassing, but it's great to see how he just shows how much he loves his family. And if you just see him with his daughter, Ivy, it's amazing, the love he has for her. But man, all joking aside, you're an excellent friend, and it's an honour to speak with you today, even though you knew I didn't want to do it. But. I've seen Martin transform from a young, shy, coy kid to a slightly less awkward adult. But in all seriousness, Martin is the friend we all turn to with our problems. He's always there for me, and I ask, you'll do. A wonderful father and someone who I've always been very proud to call a friend. He's always been there for me when I need him, no matter what the problem, and it's a pleasure to speak today. There are very important people missing today. That's Martin's dad's Lar, and his two aunties Josie and Betty, who sadly passed away. However, I know they're all looking down at Martin to see him, and they're so proud to see him marry someone who makes him so happy and give him such a beautiful daughter and neighbour. So if you'd all please raise a glass to Martin's dad, Lar, Josie and Betty. Cheers. And of course, we wouldn't be here today without Emma. It's not often that the best man is also close friends with the bride. Not that close, man. Don't worry. Emma is one of the nicest and kindest people you'll ever meet. I always tell Martin that Emma makes him look good and he's punching well above his weight. Emma, I'd just like to say how beautiful you look today. Martin could have tried a little harder, but you've done all right, you've done all right. On behalf of the groomsmen and the bridesmaids and myself, I'd like to thank Martin and Emma for letting us be a part of your special day. I know you both put a lot of hard work and effort into getting everything ready for today, and it's absolutely amazing. I could go on about Martin all day, but I'm going with my beer. It's getting very loud, and let's be honest, he's going to make a show of himself tonight anyway. I just have one last message, actually, from Martin's football team to Emer. He said, apologies, we couldn't all be here today. Good luck with Martin. We found him to be useless in most positions. So wishing you all the best in the bedroom tonight. Just try to look after him, Emma, as he struggles to look after himself. So everyone, just please raise a glass to the bride and groom. Congratulations. Memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember when I never felt so lost. And I felt all of the hatred was too powerful to stop. And my heart feels like an ember and it's lighting up the dark. Carry these torches for ya, and you know I'll never drop. Yeah. Everybody hurts sometimes. Everybody hurts someday. Yeah, yeah. But everything gon' be alright. Gonna raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. 'Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. To the ones that we lost on the way, 'cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your.
Told you I was letting go. The only joy that I have ever known. Girl, the lion. Just look around. And all of the people that we used to know. Just giving up, they wanna let it go. But we're still trying. So you should know this love we share. Never made to die. I'm glad we're on this one-way street. Just you and I. Just you.
Thank you.